Game Time, you Patriots. Today is a terrific traveling Tuesday, October 26th.
Today is the second day of Red Ribbon Week. Have you gone to the Padlet yet to write your healthy goals?
How did Red Ribbon Week get started anyway? Does anyone know?
I know. Red Ribbon Week started in 1985 after a police officer, Kiki Camarino, was killed trying to keep people safe from drugs. His mother didn't want him to become a drug enforcement special agent because it was dangerous. "I'm only one person," he told her, "but I want to make a difference." In honor of Kiki's memory and his battle against illegal drugs, friends and neighbors began to wear red badges of satin. This was the beginning of Red Ribbon Week, and it's grown into a nationwide event.
Today, we're wearing team shirts that show that athletes make healthy choices to stay in shape and perform at their best. They are courageous, resourceful, and resilient.
They need courage to try a new play and to take risks to fail so they can want to do things better next time. They are resilient and resourceful and keep trying until they are successful.
Being courageous means that sometimes we need to stand up for others or say no to a friend who wants us to do something we know is not right.
How are you courageous? Tell someone near you.
Tomorrow's theme is be open-minded to healthy food choices. We can wear mismatched or mixed up clothes to show you eat a variety of foods to stay healthy and help your body and mind grow.
Don't forget to go to the Padlet and write your health goals.
Let's talk lunch. Today for lunch we're having PB&J to-go box, lean machine combo, fish nuggets, and golden fish crackers.
Vegetable and fruit choices are garden side salad, baked beans, flavored raisins, applesauce, or juice.
It's birthday time! Today's birthdays are Jackson A. and Lucas P. in Mrs. Bunce's class, and Phoenix W. in Mrs. Bowen's class. Hope y'all have a great birthday!
It is Traveling Tuesday. Let's see if you guessed right about where Miss Greco was last week and get some clues about where she is off to this week.
Hey, Patriots, Miss Greco for our next episode of Where in the World is Miss Greco. So many of you figured out where I was located last week. I was located in the state of Alaska. I wonder what gave it away. Was it my clues? Was it what you saw behind me? Who knows? But I'm happy that you were able to figure it out. So where I'm traveling to this time, I am traveling to the continent of Europe. So you are guessing the country that I am located in the continent of Europe. So some cool facts about this country. There are over 2,000 castles in this country. That must mean they have a pretty big history. This country is one of the world's largest producers of cars. So some of the most famous car companies like BMW and Mercedes and Volkswagen, they have their companies in this country, and that's where they produce a lot of their cars from. Actually, Mercedes, which is a really expensive car brand, they use Mercedes for taxis in this country. The Christmas tree tradition started in this country. That's a cool fact. I know I love Christmas trees. Gummy bears were invented in this country. Oh, I love those too. And something really interesting in their history. So from 1961 to 1989, the country was actually divided by a physical wall that spanned 96 miles. So you might be asking yourself, well, why was this wall even put up to begin with? Well, it was put up because there were some disagreements about the governments. And so they decided to separate the country in half. So you had an east side and a west side, and they did not allow people to travel back and forth. And then in 1989, in an accidental mistake by one of their leaders, they accidentally told people that they were going to start letting people travel back and forth. And that was all it took. And people took to the streets in 1989 and famously took down this wall. All right, Patriots, let's recap your clues, see if you can figure out what country I'm in. Remember, I'm in a country in the continent of Europe. This country has over 2,000 castles. It is one of the world's largest producers of cars. The Christmas tree tradition was invented here, as well as gummy bears. And from 1961 to 1989, they very famously had a wall that was 96 miles long that separated this country. Use your sources to figure out where I am and let me know where you want me to travel to next. Have a great day.
Remember to tell Miss Greco your guesses if you see her walking around school.
It's that time again, Patriots. To wrap up our new show, please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
Then please be seated for a moment of silence.
Hi, Patriots. It's Miss Harris here. On November 11th, our country celebrates Veterans Day. Veterans Day is a day to honor and celebrate military veterans who have served in the U.S. Armed Forces. Here at Pineview, we're going to celebrate by having all of our classes join out in the middle of the courtyard for a special celebration. We'll say the pledge, we'll sing our national anthem, and we'll also do a special tribute singing the song by Lee Greenwood called Proud to Be an American. During that song, during the refrain, we all sign the lyrics. So each day on the news show from now until November 11th, you'll see a person signing the refrain to Lee Greenwood's Proud to Be an American. So you can watch, join in. So on November 11th, you'll be ready to sign with the whole school together on our ceremony. You how to sign some of the words that you're going to see, because the refrain goes pretty fast. So the beginning words are, I'm proud to be an American. In sign language, you don't sign every single word. So you're going to say I and point to yourself. There is no sign for am, but there is a sign for proud. You're going to take your thumb and you're going to draw a line up the middle of your chest. That's proud. So you say, I am proud to be an American. You'll see in the song that the girl signs the word B, which is B-E. You don't have to do that because in sign language, they don't sign all the words. So you can just say, I am proud to be an American. An American, you're going to take your fingers and lace them together. Do them in a circle, and then two lines straight down like this. So we've got, I am proud to be an American. Got it? So now you can sign those first three words. I am proud to be an American. All right, good luck today.
We hope you have a terrific Tuesday today, Patriots. We will see you back here tomorrow.
And remember, we are living the questions
by feeding our passions
and exploring our wonders.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.